Hi Steve fans and welcome back. As well as being addicted to wrecks, I also have a soft spot for sheer drop-offs. Hanging in the blue off a dramatic vertical wall is one of the most exhilarating experiences you can have underwater. Many diving locations around the world have some fantastic drop-offs, but I've selected 10 of the world's best wall diving destinations to tempt you into the abyss. For those here for the first time, my name's Mark, I'm the editor-in-chief of the Scuba Diver media brand, and welcome to the Scuba Diver YouTube channel. Remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future videos, and ring that bell so you get notification of the latest releases. Don't forget to check out below how you can get a free digital subscription to any of our magazines. That's Scuba Diver UK, Scuba Diver Australia and New Zealand, and Scuba Diver Destinations, which is our US and Canada edition. And if you want to get your hands on a print version, we've got a special subscription deal just for our YouTube followers. Now, let's dive into that video. For me, swimming off the edge of a drop-off and seeing that seemingly endless dark blue open up before you is one of the most awe-inspiring things that you can do while diving. The fact that you can often see some of the more majestic, bigger animals in the deep water off the wall is just another reason these rock dives rank highly in my list of favourite types of dive. There are innumerable destinations with wall dives on offer, but we've selected 10 of our top locations. In at number 10 is Blue Wall in Zanzibar, Tanzania. This deep, challenging wall is one of the signature dives on Southeast Zanzibar and is only offered to experienced divers who've proved their capabilities on previous deep dives with local operators. This is not a dive for the faint-hearted. You do a free descent through endless blue water until the 36-38 metre bottom comes into view. There's usually a strong current running, and as you near the seabed, it just drops away from sight. This is the top of the wall. As you go over the edge, the bottom of the wall can be seen below at about 70-75 metres. You need to have excellent air consumption, superlative buoyancy skills, and be comfortable deep and in a current. However, for experienced divers, this is a thrilling dive, offering high chances of pelagic encounters with the big boys, including large rays, yellowtail tuna, turtles, giant grouper, Napoleon wrasse, bull sharks, all set against the backdrop of a sheer wall. There's no guarantee the weather will allow you to dive Blue Wall, and whether you even get the opportunity lies entirely with the discretion of the dive centre staff. But meet the necessary criteria and you're in for a seriously wild ride. At 9 is the Maldives. When most people think of the Maldives, they conjure up images of white sandy beaches rolling into shallow turquoise waters, which in turn drop onto tranquil sheltered reefs. And yes, there's plenty of those. But there are also walls. Some of the dive sites in the Maldives can reach technical depths, and where you get those kind of depths, you naturally get a wall or two. Sites such as Markandu and Mahala all boast walls, all bursting with life and colour, as you'd expect from a Maldives dive site. These deeper areas are also commonly home to larger species of fish, including a number of decent sharks, so keep your eyes peeled. Strong currents can also be commonplace, so make sure you're comfortable with such conditions. And if you are, maybe consider taking a reef up to make things a little easier. While the walls on offer in the Maldives are perhaps on their own not the best in the world, they're a very welcome addition to the shallower offerings the area has to offer. And on account of that combination, as well as the quality of life topside, they're well worth a place on this list. At number 8 is Yapak 2 off Boracay in the Philippines. The Philippines has plenty of deep water, and as such, plenty of walls. Perhaps the best of these, though, is Yapak 2. The wall starts at 32 metres and drops to 60 metres, and currents are not uncommon. And so this is a dive for more experienced divers only. Because of the site's depth, it's the perfect spot to observe larger fish and some of the ocean's great pelagic creatures. As well as barracuda, trevally and tuna, divers can also hope to see a variety of rays, sharks, including hammerheads, and maybe even the odd mola mola. But this wall isn't just about the big stuff. Nestled in amongst the healthy corals are some of the underwater world's more delicate creatures, including nudibranchs, pygmy seahorses, so don't forget to check those sea fans as you drift past. At number 7, Great White Wall in Fiji. It's so named because of the soft white corals that cover its surface. It really is a sight, and a sight like no other. The density of the soft corals beggars belief, with the scene looking more like a ski slope than a reef. Visiting divers will have never seen anything like it. Whip corals and Gorgonian sea fans jut out from this snowy surface, breaking up the sweeping piste. While the white coral is the show stealer, there's a great deal more to this site, including a healthy reef top where hard and soft corals fight for space with sponges and crinoids. There is, of course, a large variety of reef drilling quitters to spot too. Topographically, a dive on Great White Wall is also varied. It's not just about the wall itself. Divers can enjoy swim-throughs and a cave that is absolutely smothered in life. It's also worth noting the Great Wall is subject to currents, ranging from very mild to pretty strong. So divers with limited experience are probably better off upping their experience before giving it a go. But do give it a go. It's a sight like no other. In at six is the Turks and Caicos Islands. Now, as a wall diving destination, the diminutive Turks and Caicos Islands are a global giant. The archipelago is made up of two island chains that sit atop two limestone banks. And in between these two chains is the Turks Island Passage, a Caribbean abyss that reaches down to depths of thousands of metres. While most divers tend to locate themselves in Provo or on Grand Turk, excellent diving can also be found off the other isles, such as West Caicos and Salt Key. Marine life is plentiful in these parts, including lionfish, unfortunately, with areas such as the Princess Alexander National Park having a positive impact on the health of the local underwater world. Divers can expect busy dives, keeping an eye out for all manner of creatures you'd expect to see in deep Caribbean waters, such as grouper, grunts, schools of jacks, and even turtles, rays, and eels. And sometimes you can also see sharks. Mainly Caribbean reef sharks and nurse sharks, but you can also get black tips, tiger sharks, and hammerheads on occasion. And then there are the dolphins, and if you're really lucky, maybe even a humpback whale or two. At five is Sipadan in Malaysia. The island of Sipadan is widely regarded as one of the finest wall diving destinations on the planet, and for very good reason. What makes this tiny island off the northeast coast of Borneo so special is that, unlike nearby islands such as Mabul, which slope off to relatively shallow depths, the waters off Sipadan drop to 600 metres or more. As such, all manner of pelagic marine life can be found marauding the water column, from manta rays to hammerhead sharks. In among the many turtles, both hawksbill and green, and the shows of barracuda, divers can also have the chance of seeing whale sharks. Once home to numerous dive centres, the island is now protected and only accessible by day boat, and with a limited number of spots available. As such, the reef has, in the years since this change, benefited hugely. It's now even healthier than ever. Most dive centres run two or three dives on the Sipadan walls during the day, with lunch spent on the island itself, with sheltered benches and palm tree lined beaches making for a lovely setting to off gas and chat through the great diving with your fellow guests. It's a really special day out. At four, the brothers in Egypt. Few would argue with the brothers being featured on this list. With coral clad walls dropping to technical depths, visibility that can reach in the 40 to 50 metre range, and a selection of marine life that will just about get any diver excited, it's a wall diving destination that has it all. Add to this the destination's accessibility, as far as European divers are concerned, and you really are onto a winner. Made up of two islands, that's Big Brother and Little Brother, the site is a regular on the Red Sea liverboard scene, and for very good reason. Sharks. A variety of shark species can be found in the waters around these islands, including threshers, grey reef and oceanic white tips. Hammerheads are also often spotted. Sharks tend to mean healthy reefs, and boy, are these reefs healthy. A natural protectorate since 1983, the Brothers reefs have thrived. The walls are awash with black corals, Gorgonian sea fans, and myriad other hard and soft corals. All manner of critters can be found hiding within, while schools of fish gather in the blue. Oh yeah, Big Brother also boasts two wrecks, the Aida and the Numidia. That's right folks, wreck diving on a wall. At three, Bunaken Marine Park in Indonesia. The seafloor in Bunaken Marine Park reaches to almost 2,000 metres in part. Located in the Coral Triangle and having benefited from marine park status since 1991, the deep waters here are home to a considerable array of marine life. As well as being home to nearly 400 species of coral, about 90 species of fish also inhabit the park. The variety of walls on offer is extensive, and visiting divers will no doubt leave with a list of favourites. But be warned, the competition is fierce. With clear water and walls that start from just a few metres below the surface and disappear down to technical depths, the reefs are bouncing with life, from brightly covered nudibranchs to schooling fish. The challenge is splitting your time looking through the colourful reef for critters such as scorpionfish and leafthrish, and staring at the more attention-stealing creatures such as barracuda and Napoleon wrasse that hang on the reef edge. And then there's a big blue. Don't forget to commit some decent time to that, or you might miss the various sharks, rays and turtles that cruise around on a regular basis. And the occasional whale shark, of course. In at number two, Bloody Bay Wall on Little Cayman in the Cayman Islands. Little Cayman is regarded by some as the wall diving destination, and it's mostly because of Bloody Bay Wall, an undersea cliff face off the north of the island that drops to thousands of metres. The thing that makes this site so spectacular is something of a surprise. Yes, sharks occasionally patrol the waters, and other impressive creatures such as barracuda and turtles can be seen, but they're not the highlight. Diving Bloody Bay Wall is all about the sponges. No, that's not a mistake. The colours are incredible. Red rope sponges, orange vase sponges, emerald tube sponges, they all fight for your attention, along with fiery basket sponges. It's this dense, colourful backdrop that makes the scene so special. The sponges are a particular treat for photographers, who are guaranteed vivid foregrounds as they busily snap shots of grouper, jacks and barracuda. And of course, the aforementioned sharks if they show up. Best of all, as part of the Bloody Bay Marine Park, this site is guaranteed to remain a true diving spectacle for years to come. And in at one, Blue Corner in Palau. Palau's Blue Corner is not for the faint-hearted. Easily the Republic's most famous dive site, Blue Corner consists of a ridge that juts out into deep Pacific waters and has typically punchy currents. The strength and unpredictability of these currents makes this a dive for advanced divers only. Those with suitable experience will not be disappointed. The currents, as well as being great fun, bring in plenty of nutrients, which in turn attract fish life of various sizes all the way up the food chain. So once you've soaked up the health of the reef itself, which includes a multitude of soft corals, gorgonian sea fans and anemones, you'll be able to focus your attention on the bigger stuff. Huge schools of jacks, snapper and barracuda to name but a few. And the even bigger stuff, sharks. Below, to the side, overhead, the sharks are everywhere. Mantas are also not an uncommon sight. Because the currents can be so strong, reef hooks are commonly used. The upwelling currents can pop you up and over the wall with ease. Hooks are especially useful if you're a photographer and need both hands to operate your equipment. More generally speaking, it's just nice to hook in and watch the show. And it is one hell of a show. This is our selection of iconic wall diving sites, but there are many, many more. What are some of your favourite wall dives? Leave your comments below, and if you have a question, fire away. Because if we can't answer it, maybe someone in our community will be able to. Remember, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And don't forget, you can grab a free digital magazine subscription in the description below. As always, stay safe. And if you're one of the lucky people who's living somewhere where you can get out and dive, enjoy!